wants to talk with us about map management chisels, white maps have been, I want to hear your opinion, order here, a lot of streamers. Well, GG solo. My opinion is going to be different than everybody else's, although probably everyone is now doing the way that I've always said to do maps. In my opinion, when you're doing maps, given that you're sealing 78, okay, and 66 is worthless, if you want to do maps to build your map pool, you really shouldn't roll anything except 69 plus. I mean, a transmute and, like, I don't know, it's like, the problem with rolling it is there are mods you don't want to do, so it's almost better to do them white. When they're below 66, 67, 68, you can just do white. Assuming you've done Lunaris and Docks and stuff early in the league, and have built up your map pool to 20 maps. Then you save all your chisels for 74 plus, 73, 73 is canyon, so like 73 plus you chisel. From 69 to 72, you roll them well, not amazing. That's just my opinion. It's too much to deal with the randomness of maps. Like, however well you roll them, unless you alk cast to insane rolls, your return's never going to be predictable. Your goal is to get a map base of 5, say 5 to 10, 71 to 74s, and have 4 or 5 other people with the same base. Then from there, you all roll great maps. Above 73, which you're chiseling, you want to alt regal. I guess I'm going to go ahead and do this one vegan. Since he's still in my group. What was I going to say? And I think that's how you do it. I didn't buy any maps last league. I bought some 78s just for the final push to 90. Because I really didn't want to waste time. And I maintained all the way up to 78, no problem, just doing the method that I said. The method has always worked. In previous leagues, people called it the Moore's method. People derided me for how I said to do maps. They call it, like, pussy maps. I mean, Rox is the one who coined the term, but in Crip's Mumble, playing with Crip. So, I mean, this was a lot of people thought it was stupid, just because I guess it was repeated on Crip's Mumble. This is, by the way, with no evidence to the contrary. Okay. I had done my limited testing, and I said, I thought this was better because you invested far less currency, the alt-regal method. Everyone felt you had to exalt maps, eat up exalted maps. Earlier today I played with Greg Zahn, and I said to him, well, there's a guy in his group who was a jerk, who I didn't want to play with. Which, by the way, it's really funny to look at your PoE logs in the game, because it keeps, if you don't delete the file, it keeps lock from everything you've ever seen typed in chat. So I found the conversation that made me hate this guy. It's really kind of a funny convo from over a year ago. But 50% of the reason I stopped mapping with Greg Zahn and Onslaught was that, one, this dude totally turned me off. But two, they exalted well-rolled maps. Now, he was buying 77 maps for an exorbitant fee. So for him, exalting one or two maps every 15 maps he rolled, or maybe more, like they exalt 4 out of the 15. But I thought that was crazy, because you wouldn't get anything good, and that's so much chaos, you could use the chaos other maps to elite status. So I just stopped doing it, I couldn't justify spending the currency. So now they've changed maps, where maps have size. But as we've seen, people roll insane maps now, which is magic size, which is all you needed in the previous thing, and then you regal it. So a current map regaled with magic has size implicit, all maps have the size. Regal, two other mods. You can sometimes have 50 quant maps, which in the old way, would have had to have rolled all that shit. And like in the previous way, well rolled maps like that didn't drop anything, and they don't drop anything sometimes now. So basing any results off a long term thing is silly. Because yes, probably over 3,000 maps, the harder you roll the maps, the more return you're gonna get. But in all honesty, if you're running 3,000 maps, you have such a huge map pool of 74s and 75s, if you're trying to run 77s, 78s, that it's only people who are, like, super something where they're going to be like, I can't ever run a 75 map, which is nuts. Still get fine XP. I'm just getting free. I'm just staying group with these guys and getting free fucking masters right now. That's so funny. But yeah, so I mean, I really think that the correct way is now the way that everyone's doing the maps. So, okay. I don't know if you would really say that I was vindicated in the long term because it's an unknowable thing. That's the problem with stuff like that. I got my chaos. I was like, I didn't even see it. So yeah, anyway, that's my opinion on maps. I haven't looked at chat in a while, or my chat was scrolled up, so I'm probably missing some comments from people. Yeah, magic monsters or pack size always. You must get either magic or pack size. Magic monsters or pack size. Required on all of your top maps. You're getting there. I was ahead of my time. Now, in fairness, yes, the way ETOP and some of these other people did maps was going to give you more maps on average over a huge long term, and the odds of you dying in a minus max map, which people, by the way, ran all the fucking time, which is insane and so stupid. People died all the time doing that dumb shit. All the time. I mean, the main reason I have so few deaths is I don't do dumb shit, and I'm just like accepting that I'm gonna do one level of maps down. Now, we're not talking about a 1 week race. A 1 week race, you run the max map you have almost all the time, rolled as best as you can, based on your currency. But that's a different thing. That's a 1 week race. I mean, only until recently could people win a long-term league and hit 100, which I don't like that change. I don't think you should be able to hit 100 in less than 6 months. But again, that's just my opinion. I understand if, Morsexier invented mapping.